Today is March 30th, Saturday, and I'm up early in the morning. I'm going to go out to that Wanaka tree, which is a Instagram sensation of this tree that kind of grows just on the edge of the lake in the water. So we're going to go take a look and see and hopefully get some Instagram-worthy pictures. Walking around downtown Wanaka, and I'm gonna go look for some tacos and Mexican food. Much better lighting. Not that it's not beautiful, but I can't see the snow-capped mountains quite as well. It's time of day. Today is March 31st, and it is a beautiful Sunday. So this is my last day. Later this afternoon, I will be driving into Queenstown and then dropping off the car after I get settled into my little studio that I have rented there. So I've had quite the adventure, but I'm looking forward to a little bit of downtime and a little less driving. But yes, this is Lake Wanaka and it is beautiful. Here we've stopped just outside of a little town called Cadrona, which is between Wanaka and Queenstown. I didn't stop in the town itself because I do have to return my car soon, but we are going through these beautiful, nice brown mountains that do remind me of the mountains back home. But yeah, this is kind of my last little leg of my trip. As I pull into Queenstown, I'll head to my studio and then I will return my car. Overlook of Queenstown. Home sweet home. Thank you. we finally come to the end. I am here in my little studio that I'm temporarily staying at while I find housing and a job here in Queenstown. So this marks the end of day 10 of my grand New Zealand road trip. I dropped off my little Toyota Yaris this morning after driving from Wanaka back here to Queenstown. Overall, the total kilometers that it took me to get from Auckland to Queenstown was 1,799 kilometers, which is equal to 1,118 miles. If I were to do it again, I would absolutely follow the same trek. So if you are considering doing a New Zealand road trip to go across country, absolutely stop in all the same places that I did. It gives you about somewhere between 3 and 5 hours between each destination, depending on like me, who likes to stop and take lots of photos along the way. I did have only one hiccup, and then I had to stay an extra night in Auckland in order to access my storage unit, so did not get to spend a night in Waitomo. But otherwise, the only change that I would make for next time that I do this is that I want to start in Queenstown and head up to Auckland. But otherwise, I can highly suggest all of these places. They were wonderful, and you absolutely need to see them for yourself. So thanks for traveling along this journey with me, and hope to see you sometime in New Zealand soon. I do it for myself. I'm dancing for no one else. I do it for myself, baby. Turn the lights down, baby, and turn it up to something we know. Never felt so crazy, haven't slept in days. I'm burning up, baby.